Vasopressin, indications for early use. Martin Balik, Department of Anesthesiology and Intensive Care, Charles University, General University Hospital, Prague, EU.
I would say that indications for vasopressin as an early agent would be not only the refractory vasoparalysis at this level of catecholamines or norepinephrine, but I would say that there's a primary indication for vasopressin to be used as a solo agent in someone who has got LVOTO, where we would aim to completely stop the norepinephrine or at least get it, in my practice, under 0.1 microgram per kilo per minute. I would definitely love to use vasopressin in someone who has got pulmonary hypertension and a right ventricular problem. I would use the vasopressin early to decatecholaminize patients, as it was outlined in a brilliant talks this morning, and definitely prevent Takotsubo-related cardiomyopathy with vasopressin. I would facilitate my rhythm control in supraventricular arrhythmia with vasopressin. I would love to protect the kidneys with vasopressin. And I would also think that someone who comes to my ICU with a prolonged sepsis might have a depletion of endogenous vasopressin. And in my unit, anyone who is in septic shock beyond 4 days would definitely, I guess, according to the data we have available, would have a depletion of vasopressin and would benefit from its substitution. And I think that's all. Thank you very much for your attention.